IFFI has always been a ground where a lot of beautiful non-feature films, documentaries are always screened. So we have today with us two document the team of two documentary films which are being screened under Indian Panorama. So first, let me introduce you to Divya Karnale, director of P for Paparazzi, a 26 minutes documentary. And we also have with us the co-producer, Yugandhar Salvi. Welcome. And the second film is called Bahi, Tracing My Ancestors. It's a documentary of 9 minutes in Hindi. And we have with us Rachita Gorowala, director. Welcome. So I would also at the outset like to state that this press conference is being and okay. So let's first see the trailers of the films. First, P for Paparazzi. Wonderful, very interesting. And paparazzis, we all know, form an important part of the ecosystem of film industry, of celebrities. They are the people who make the people who are famous, who they are, bring name and fame to them. So we'll know more about the film from the director. But before that, oh, yes, and I would also like to introduce you to the cinematographer Pushkar Sarnaik, who's sitting in the front row, and Pranav Patil, editor of the film. Welcome to you both, too. Coming to Bahi, Tracing My Ancestors, it's a very important topic that Rachita has touched upon. It's about some traditions of our ancient civilization. So let's see the trailer first. Wonderful. This film brings to the fore an age-old tradition which is going on for ages in Haridwar, one of the holiest cities of India. So we'll know more about the film. We'll start with the opening remarks of the director. First, let us listen to the director of P for Paparazzi, Divya. Over to you.
This is my first official press conference, and I don't know how it's done, but I'll try my best. So hi, I'm Divya, the director of P for Paparazzi. This is a film that was firstly started with the initiative that because I was very interested in this world of as to how and why these paparazzis function and the kind of chaos and frenzy that surrounds their lives. And I was mainly interested into peeking into the lives of people who peek into other people's lives and what happens when the camera turns to them. So that was my intent while making the film. And then eventually we started to explore what we could do and what possibilities we could achieve.
All right, Jugender, would you like to add something?
I think it has been a great experience working on this film with Divya. So basically, we all are friends and we have been working together for a few years. And it feels really good when you get funds for your film and your film is actually being made and it gets selected to film festivals and you get all the attention and recognition you deserve. So thank you so much, Effie.
Yeah, thank you.
I just heard from them just before the press conference started that Manoj Mahara, the central character on whom the film has been shot, is here in IFFI ground, but he has got busy in his work of tracking A.R. Rahman, so he's not attending the press conference. So he's busy in his work. He's carrying on with his work. Okay, now let us hear about Bahi, tracing my ancestors. So over to you.
Thank you for having me here. Bahi is a very, very old tradition, and I think much of you would have understood with the trailer that it's a record keeping which the Tirth Purohit community of Haridwar does. So what fascinated us was not the cacophony of rituals, but the fact that there's a philosophy and there is a eternalness to the Ganges, and the fact that this tradition has been continuing for 20 odd generations was something which was extremely philosophical and existential. When we saw tattered papers, पुरानी इंक, ये सब देख के हम लोगों को बहुत ऐसे लगा था कि मतलब वो पोएट्री एकदम हमारे प्रत्यक्ष रूप में सामने आ गई. सो वर्चुअल भारत के लिए हमने ये फिल्म बनाई जो एसेंशियली हिंदुस्तान की ऐसी कहानियां जो अनकही हैं उन पे लाइट डालते हैं, एंड बही हैपन्स टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ दैट. द फिल्म was something which lent itself to a lot of design. So we really went ahead and designed this film shot by shot. It's not shot like a documentary, it's shot literally like a fiction film. And we हमारे लिए प्राइमरी था इवोकेशन, कहानी बोलना वॉज सेकेंडरी, बट इवोक करना एक इमोशन को वॉज द प्राइमा फेसी स्टाइल दैट वी सॉर्ट ऑफ टुक. एंड या आई मीन हमने शायद इस फिल्म में टोटल 40 शॉट लिए होंगे. हम हर दिन सिर्फ 2 शॉट लेते थे क्योंकि हम इतना ज़्यादा एक एक चीज़ को डिज़ाइन कर रहे थे, एक एक चीज़ को एकदम माप करके बना रहे थे. सो आई थिंक दैट टू मी वॉज द मोस्ट फैसिनेटिंग पार्ट, बिकॉज मेरा सब जो FTI का नॉलेज था वो सब घुसा दिया मैंने इस फिल्म में. सो या दैट वॉज
And you
या
said that the
भाई
film was made in 9 days.
Yes, it
Yes.
took a while because obviously you shoot 4 shots a day, then obviously you're shoot. And the best part is you have a producer like Bharat Bala who's looking at your frame and saying, take your time, which never happens. I think when you're, and it's great that something like that happens with a platform like Virtual Bharat. So I'm very happy that we got the chance to make the film the way we did.
So I would like to inform you all that Rachita is into filmmaking for the last 10 years. He has done commercials. She has done shooting for commercials of Google, Virtual Bharat,
Yes.
Amazon, Tanishq, and she has made a lot of documentaries for Films Division. So I would like to ask you, and that how did this topic come to your mind? Why did you choose this topic?
Okay, so this topic came to me from the research pool of Virtual Bharat. They said this is a tradition which happens somewhere in the Char Dhams, and there was a story which we found on YouTube which somebody had previously done. I don't remember their name. So I just saw 2.5 minute video on it, और उतना ही बस नॉलेज था हमारे पास, उससे ज़्यादा मैं पता नहीं था. सो We booked the next flight. I was sent to Haridwar to do recce and research at the same time. So everything happened on the go. And I read about it very little, I would say. Whatever I kind of gathered was through conversations. And I'd like to say that one of the things which perhaps created the germ of this idea was that one of these people whose voice is there in the film said that ये जो हमारे बच्चे होते हैं ये मछली के बच्चे के जैसे होते हैं, इनको सिखाना नहीं पड़ता, ये देख देख के सीख जाते हैं. सो दैट बेसिकली बिकेम लाइक द आइडिया ऑफ ओके, लेट मी पुट अ किड इन द फिल्म और थ्री किड्स एंड लेट मी स्पेंड अ डे और एक्सप्लोर अ डे इन अ लाइफ ऑफ अ तीर्थ पुरोहित किड. दैट एसेंशियली बिकेम द आइडिया ऑफ द फिल्म.
ऑलराइट, नाउ पी फॉर पपरवाजी. सो आई वुड ऑल्सो लाइक टू नो दैट व्हाई डिड यू चूज दिस टॉपिक.
या सो previously I had made this film called 15 Seconds a Lifetime, which was based in the world of TikTok when it was massive in India, before it was banned in India. At that period of time, I was just researching, and we were almost on the verge of completing that film. And at that period of time, there was a germ in my mind that maybe I'm very much interested in the world of these paparazzis and what do they do, why do they function, how do they function, all these things. And the another peak point was when I was a kid, I used to come home every day and read the newspapers. And the second thing that I used to do, so the first thing, I wanted to become a football player, so I used to read the sports section. But the second thing that I used to do was Hindustan Times aata tha mere ghar par. So I used to, after looking at the sports section, I used to go to the Bombay Times, where all these celebs were papped every day. But at that period of time, I did not know ki itna bhaga dodi hota in sab cheezo ke piche, or so much of hard work, and like there are people madly running behind these photos to get these captured, vagera vagera. So I was like, when I grew up, then I was very much interested ki what goes behind getting these photos and what happens in their personal lives, what comes at a cost. And in media, there was a certain kind of portrayal about paparazzis that was one-sided, I felt, and I wanted to kind of show ki agar hum ise aur ek side se dekhe to, like for any profession, I was seeing that we were just looking down upon them. Like a lot of people in the internet circuit were looking down upon them. But what if we just look them as humans, like as you would look for a doctor, the approach you would have for a doctor or an engineer, the respect you would have for such a person. Like, why can't we have such a respect for someone who's clicking photos for a living? That was my interest and peak point into this.
So, like you were saying, that Manoj Mahara is camera shy. Though he likes to take photos of famous people and celebrities, he doesn't want to come in front of the camera yourself.
Yeah.
So it had been a little. So you have to approach it in a different way. So would you like to tell about that story and that is how you rewrote the script? You told me.
Yeah.
So,
no.
Yeah.
Like, there was no script as such. Like, there are just approaches and treatments you have in your mind while making a documentary. You don't have a certain set of rules towards making it, but like you have a mota mota idea. So one thing that I had, that the film was going to happen in the backdrop of Diwali. That was the only thing in my mind. I wanted to show this chaos. These two things were the only thing in my mind when I was starting to develop the film and I had started to pitch it to others. But eventually what happened was, luckily, I chanced upon Manoj, and once I chanced upon Manoj, he was first shy when I was shooting it. Like the first 3-4 days, he was shy. But after a period of time, he got so used to me that he eventually became a friend-like person, and then he just opened up. So for example, in the first month of the film, what was happening is that he had told me first 3-4 days mein ki shooting karna koi problem nahi, mere ghar pe mat aana bas. Okay, that was the thing. And I did not know the conflict that is there in the film right now. I did not know about that. So, usne ye clearly bola tha. But in the 4th-5th month when we were shooting, he was like, "Arey Divya, kab ghar pe aa raha hai?" So then it was like a constant, like that over a period of 4-5 months, that relationship built over a period of time. And he gained that trust. And I also kind of felt that trust and that access towards him. And therefore, I could go into his house after a period of time. So, but he was much open, and like the kind of life he has shown on in the film, I don't think anyone would be daring enough to show these things.
The film takes us through the harsh realities that Manoj has to face, and it's about the problems he faces in his life. So I will be seeing the film. So I urge you all to also see the film. And so let us take some questions from the audience. Who would like to ask? Yes.
Rachita, you have made this film from the Haridwar Bahi.
Yes.
Yeah? Have you researched about the same kind of Bahi tradition in other parts of India?
I know of them. Okay. I haven't gone deep into research. I know charo dhamo mein hota hai aisa ki jab koi guzar jata hai ya koi paida hota hai ya koi dip lene aata hai kisi holy river mein to likhte hain bahi khate. But mujhe gaya ka pata hai, mujhe banaras ka pata hai, mujhe haridwar ka pata hai, mujhe aur zyada nahi pata.
Is there any plan for other documentary kind of for more
for this particular idea? No. But definitely, I have done two more films with Bharat Bala sir, and one of them is on the Kumauni Thali, which is their food traditions, which are unfortunately getting lupt ho rahe hain, getting lost. Apart from that, I've also done a film called Women of Munshiari, which celebrates the women of the Uttarakhand Kumauni region, and unka ek बहुत खूबसूरत मॉडल विलेज है जहाँ पे सारी जो प्राइमरी पोजीशंस हैं वो औरतों ने ली हैं फ्रॉम द सरपंच टू जो ग्रेनरी हेड करती हैं जो जंगल की पेट्रोलिंग करती हैं हर जगह औरतें हैं सो इट्स अ वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग मॉडल और बहुत खूबसूरत फिल्म है वो भी यूट्यूब पे है वो जो भारत के चैनल पे आपको वक्त मिले तो आप देखिए 10 मिनट की फिल्म है थैंक यू
Rachita, could you please throw some more light, particularly on your research, the background study, maybe your interaction with them, how you did it, and how was the experience? I'm interested to know that, actually.
Okay, so the experience was very beautiful when it was a mixed experience. I think there's a lot of chaos in Haridwar, you know, and we had to really make a very silent film. So we had to choose and कुछ था भी उस time पे festival था शायद तो बहुत भीड़ रहती है लोगों की और जो जितने श्रद्धालु होते हैं वो लोग बस आते हैं फटाक से उनको dip लेना होता है तो हमने एक बहुत remote location choose करी and fortunately हमें एक ऐसी location मिली जो एकदम out of space लग रही थी because इतनी अस्थियां दहाते हैं लोग अपनी गंगा में कि उनके जो आसपास के पत्थर हैं वो भी ग्रे हो गए हैं मतलब वो इतने सालों से इतने ज़्यादा जनरेशन से वो चीज़ें हो रही हैं तो हमें वो एक लोकेशन मिल गई जो जिस तरह का ट्रीटमेंट हम चाहते थे फिल्म का जो कि बहुत ज़्यादा इनफाइनाइट और कंटिन्यूटी और कंटिन्यूम को दर्शाता है उसके लिए हमें बहुत अप्रोप्रिएट वो जगह मिल गई हमने बच्चों के साथ शूट करना प्रेफर किया बिकॉज जब हम लोग रिसर्च कर रहे थे तो हमको भी एकदम ऐसा लग रहा था कि हम डॉट हैं बड़े से यूनिवर्स में इतना ज़्यादा एक क्राइसिस में चला जाता है आदमी जब इतनी सारी डेथ देख लेते हो आप आसपास सो एसेंशियली वो हमने मतलब दैट वाज अ ट्रीटमेंट कॉल वी टुक बिकॉज मैंने 3-4 दिन वहाँ गुजारे और मुझे समझ में आया कि अरे बाप रे ये तो बहुत ज़्यादा मतलब यू नो फिलोसॉफिकल जगह है और ये लाइफ एंड डेथ को इतना यू नो इतनी एकदम आपकी आंखों के सामने आप देखते हो तो सो वहाँ से हमारी फिल्म का ट्रीटमेंट आया और हम बिल्कुल इसको प्रिस्टीन और प्योरिटी के लेंस से और इनफाइनाइट के लेंस से देखना चाहते थे तो आप अगर बही के जहाँ पे बहियाँ रखी हैं वो भी देखें तो आपको दिखेगा कि हमने उसको भी बहुत इनफाइनाइट दिखा के शूट किया है आप उनकी लाइंस भी देखें तो भी उसमें आपको एक कंटिन्यूटी का एहसास होगा जिस तरह से हमने उनके धागे शूट किए हैं उसमें भी तो हर चीज़ को हमने इस तरह से दर्शाने की कोशिश करी डिड आई आंसर योर क्वेश्चन
Hi, Rachita. I am Namita. I am a senior journalist in Goa. आप 10 साल से फिल्म मेकिंग में हैं वहीं पर नहीं है मेरा सवाल मेरा सवाल ये है कि पिछले 10 सालों में आप क्या फर्क देखती हैं विमेन इन फिल्म मेकिंग में आप कैसे रखती हैं इसको
बहुत आपने बड़ा कॉम्प्लिकेटेड सवाल पूछा है बट इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आई थिंक आई डेफिनेटली सी अ लॉट ऑफ चेंज फॉर द बेटर आई फील दैट बिकॉज ऑफ एक्सेस एंड बिकॉज ऑफ अ वॉइस आई थिंक समवेयर अ लॉट ऑफ वीमेन हैव कम टू द फोर एज फिल्म मेकर्स आई सी माई सेल्फ if I can speak for myself a little bit, I'd say that I've found the way I want to make films, and I've found platforms where I can tell stories the way I want to tell them. So I think wo ek aapke andar courage agar aa gaya, matlab aapke aas pas paraphernalia mein cheeze theek hi chal rahi hain. So I feel ek definitely wo cheez hai. With respect to the scenario in general, I feel a lot of filmmakers have really shown and made India proud in the last year. Nidhi Saxena ki Busan mein film jati hai, Payal Kapadia ki Cannes mein film jati hai, Santosh, you know, Guneet Monga ek Oscar jeeti hai. Kya ho raha hai? Matlab, it's such a beautiful time to be a woman filmmaker. I think I am very happy, and I really feel that perhaps this is going to be, from here on, I think it's our time is going to start and how. I feel.
Definitely, our women filmmakers are making us proud at the global stage. And speaking of Divya, I would like to mention that he had participated in Creative Minds of Tomorrow. So Divya here has come up to the press conference stage. And his association with IFFI goes back to 2021, when he had participated in Creative Minds of Tomorrow. So really, that's great. So, and yes, yes, please go ahead, madam.
पहले तो आपको बहुत congratulate कर दूं, क्योंकि इतने young age में आपने इतनी खूबसूरत सोच को आपने documentary में ढाला है. So सरल है, बहुत सरल फिल्म है, आपने भी बनाया होगा, बट द सरल इज द मोस्ट कॉम्प्लेक्स थिंग. आपने उसको इतनी खूबसूरती से उतारा है डॉक्यूमेंट्री में, कैसे?
सो इट्स अ प्रोसेस. आई फील आई डोंट हैव आंसर्स टू इट फ्रॉम डे वन, एंड द बेस्ट पार्ट अबाउट इट इज लाइक हैविंग अ टीम दैट काइंड ऑफ बिलीव्स इन यू. सो आई फील लाइक दिस दैट कम्स इन विद द टीम दैट आई हैव, बिकॉज माई टीम हैजंट चेंज्ड इन द फिल्म्स दैट आई हैव मेड. It's been the same with every film. We have made 4 films together now, and the team hasn't changed much. So the credit lies over there. And it's also, for me, it's about not having answers. It's about trying to find answers with making a film. So with like, and there lies the credit, because I am, look, as the director, people feel that the director should know everything. I say I don't know everything. I am just figuring out things. So in every stage of the film, we are figuring out things. So like in the pre-production, how is it going to be? While shooting also, we are figuring out kahan camera lagega, kahan se mic lagega, kahan better sound capture ho sakta hai. Hum sab trial error karke dekhte hai. And that's always because we have been always a 3-person crew maximum while shooting. And then edit mein Pranav has always been there. So with Pranav also, then in the edit process, we are figuring out as to chalo isme se kya abhi bana sakte hai. And then is there something, anything else to shoot? Then we'll go and shoot some patchwork. So it's a constant trial and error that we are constantly doing, which happens over a period of time. And for that, you need people who trust you and are ready to give you that time. So I am very happy that I have those people around me. And that's where the kind of effort, matlab wo jo kuch bhi nikal ke aata hai, wo wahan se aata hai.
Of course, filmmaking is always a teamwork. Of course. And Divya's first film, 15 Seconds of Lifetime, had premiered at the New York Indian Film Festival in 2022 and had been to 10 other festivals around the world also. Yeah. Awesome. And coming to you, Rachita, so are you taking this film to other festivals also? And where can we see it? What are your distribution plans?
So you guys can watch it. It's very accessible. It's on the Virtual Bharat channel on YouTube. It's one of the most accessible films, I would say. But I would love to, I mean, we are of course going to send it to many more festivals, because watching it on the big screen was another experience. I think it's like a big screen watch. So, yeah.
Okay. And what about you, Divya? How will you launch your films? Any plans? What?
Let's see. I don't have answers to that, but I am happy that this was the first film where we got funding before making the film.
Wow.
Rest all films, humne filme banai fir fund dhoonde hai. This was the first film where we had the money. So I'm hoping that this will see the light of the day, because there's PSBT backing us.
Wow.
So they are the producers as of now, and Yugandhar is the co-producer. So we'll figure out a way. But currently we are doing some festival rounds. It's just started. So November has been very tight for us. We had like 3 festivals.
So this it premiered
month.
In IFFI. It did its Asia premiere?
So basically, so it world premiered at the Kerala Film Festival, and then Dharamshala was there, and then IFFI has happened.
Okay.
And then it has gone to Film South Asia. Next month it's screening in River to River Florence Indian Film Festival. So yeah.
Okay.
And then we have sent it to a lot many film festivals, but let's see. I don't know how many of them select us.
Very nice. Congratulations once again to both of you, and all the best.